Hi, Jim Beckler with the RV Corral. I'd like to welcome you to our website and thank you for taking the time to take a look at a motorhome with me. I'd like to show you a motorhome we just got in on trade. It's a really nice Winnebago. It's 2003. It's a 33V is the model on this, so it has two slide outs, really a great floor plan. Not too big, but big enough to be comfortable, but easy to get into a lot of spots that maybe some of the bigger motorhomes actually wouldn't be accessible. So actually this is a very popular floor plan with Winnebago. So we'll take a look at this motorhome. I think you'll really appreciate the way this is laid out. One of the things for starters that this one does have the driver's side door, so you do have access into the motorhome from the driver's side. Makes it nice. Now this is also built on a workhorse chassis, so this has the heavier chassis with the Vortec, the 8.1 liter Vortec V8 engine, so it's got plenty of power, lots of torque to pull a car behind you. Great setup for a car, for a motorhome this size. Actually good combination of power and performance and handling. So let's take a look around over here on the other side. One thing I'd like to point out too is it does have a nice big awning. Take a look at the size of your patio awning there. It's that's probably about 22 feet long. It's good, covers your whole patio side. Great to set up a nice little place out here to enjoy those nice evenings, maybe when you're out RVing. Good storage in this too. This has a lot of pass-through storage. Has a little compartment right there with access to your hot water heater. You can actually turn your hot water heater on from out here. Access to your water pump and your winterization, all of that's right in that compartment, easy to get to. Notice how big the doors are. Nice big openings. Even has more storage back up in there. You can see your, if you take a look back up in there, you can see your water tanks are actually protected from the elements because they're tucked right up in there in between the bottom of your motorhome and the floor of your coach. More storage back in through here. There's your access to your propane tank. Got a nice propane tank. This unit, like I said, does have two slide outs. So you have a bedroom slide out and then our main slides on the other side of the motorhome, which we'll take a look over there in just a second. Notice it does have an awning over the slide out, so that'll help protect the top of your awning or the top of your slide out. Keep it from getting debris build up there and keep it a little drier too when you get those hard rains. I like the fact they have the vent back here too for your furnace. It's a nice area to have that vented because most of the time you're not going to be back here spending much time in the back of your motorhome. It has a backup camera on top. A ladder to get up on top of your motorhome. Has a one-piece fiberglass roof, which makes it nice because it's going to be very durable and stays looking good for longer periods of time than the rubber roofs. This has a nice 5,500 watt on-end generator. So the motorhome does have 50 amp power cord, so you have plenty of power going into your coach. It will run everything that you need. So you have separate compartments, one for your power, one for your water systems. This is hookup for holding your black tank, and it actually has a little black tank flush, so you can hook up a hose to that and clean out your black tank. Everything's pretty easy to get to. Notice here, there's a little label on this door. All your doors with Winnebago, they put a label on everything. Almost every part in here has its own label. And the reason they do that is if you ever need to replace it, if you need a part for something, like we could call the factory, and with these numbers, they'd know exactly what it came off of. This particular unit, the interior decor, everything. And so they make almost all their own parts, so they don't have to rely on vendors to hope they still have a part available, since they make their own parts that are easy to get. Now, one of the other things that's nice about Winnebago is they use a store mower system. So notice the large storage compartment that comes out with the slide out, so you don't have to crawl underneath the slide out to get to your storage. It actually comes out with the slide out, so you can get to your storage without having to do too much aerobic exercising there and try to get underneath that. It's a nice clean motorhome. The people that traded it just ended up getting another coach. So let's take a look inside. Now for starters, let's take a look up front here. Like I'd mentioned, it does have the Workhorse chassis, which is a great driving chassis. This motorhome will roll down the road very nicely. Notice over here you do have your hydraulic leveling system, so it does have hydraulic levelers. It has a backup camera, and again the driver's side door with you actually have an electric window on that door as well. Here's your backup camera, and then your TV up in front. You can see your front seats are going to spin around in this, and you have another nice little recliner as well. Good seating available for this particular layout. It does have a sleeper sofa also. This makes into a bed right here, and the dinette booth will break down into a bed also. Plus you do have extra storage underneath here, which makes it nice. Actually, the way they designed this, you can just flip up the bottom of the seat and access all that storage below without having to break the whole thing down. Winnebago actually makes a lot of their own furniture too, so they build a very high percentage of their motorhome at their facility, so makes it nice. You have very consistent quality, and availability of parts is a huge factor. Good storage in this one. In the kitchen area, it does have a little flip up counter extension right here too, so you've got a good layout here. Has a nice size microwave, and the gas oven down below here. This is a larger gas oven. This is a 22 inch oven, the bigger oven with the nice little 3-burner stovetop. Refrigerator is gas electric, so it'll operate off of either or with an ice maker. And it does have a nice little slide out pantry as well. Again, that's something that Winnebago puts in almost all their motorhomes. Nice little drawers down below here too. Good place for pots and pans and miscellaneous storage. Now, if you take a look at this panel right here, you notice almost all your controls are in one spot, so they're very easy to get to. Centrally located in your motorhome. This unit does have a True Air residential heating and air conditioning system. It's like a heat pump system that you'd have in your home. It's a residential style heat pump. So instead of having roof airs, it has basement air, and it's much more efficient. It's quieter, and just it actually will heat and cool your coach a lot more efficiently than the air conditioner that's put up on the roof. Plus you have a little lower center of gravity. Most of your weight's down below rather than up on top of your motorhome. You also have your controls, or your you can check your tanks right here. Check your battery system right here. See what kind of voltage you have in your batteries. This power line system is an energy management system. Basically what this is going to do is it monitors the power that you're using inside your coach. So bottom line is, if you were using too much on one system, this would actually direct, maybe if you were running a hair dryer plus you had the microwave on and maybe another appliance all in one circuit, it would cut the power to one of the circuits before it's going to blow a fuse or throw a breaker. Generator controls from right here, water pump, water heater, etc. All nice and easy to get to. Take a look at the nice shower in this too. This has a nice little corner shower. Good size shower. The little skylight above. Let's see, lots of light. Sink and vanity. All in this area here. And your commode area right here with a window. Like I had mentioned, you do have a slide out in the bedroom area too. It gives you more space in the bedroom here. Good area to be able to dress and a nice walk around bed. Windows on both sides of the bed makes it nice. You get not only ventilation, but you get more light when you if you'd like to have light coming in. Speaking of that, they do have shades, so if you want to block out the sun, you have the day shades, and then you have the night shades for at night where you can close off that, get a little more privacy. Good storage back here also. Nice big closet, cedar line in the back. And lots of drawers down below here as well, so you've got good storage. Even has a little vanity right here, or a little dressing area with another window and a TV above. Like I mentioned, it's a great layout, really nice, popular floor plan. If you're looking for a nice motorhome, then maybe you want something that's going to be comfortable but not too big, this could be the one right here. It's 2003 Winnebago 33V Adventure, which is Winnebago's one of their higher trim levels, so it's equipped very nicely. Love to show you the motorhome. Come see me if you would. Just ask for Catfish Jim. That's what they call me down here, so look me up. I'll be glad to help. Thank you.